Welcome to Quantum Grade, our third episode on the third question on the sample paper. So now we have the question here. Assuming the fragment below, which three code fragments reproduce the circuit illustrated? We have three codes. INP underscore red, which is a quantum register with two qubits. Name it as INP. And then we have another one, ANCilla, which is a quantum register with one qubit. And name it as ANC. And then we have quantum circuit QC. We put all these two quantum registers together and then we form the quantum circuit. If we insert the correct option from A to F, six options. So we can generate the quantum diagram as shown in the question, so which has HHX as our quantum gates. So which one should we choose correctly? So let's get started. So let's open the Jupyter notebook and get our hand dirty. Now we can run the first code by importing the package by pressing Shift Enter. And I will go through all the options with you to see which one should be correct or not for the first option. So now we just import the three codes, the INP underscore red, and CELA, and QC. I name it as A for the option A. And then now I just copy and paste the code shown in the option A. So we have QCA.H with the parentheses INP underscore red, and the second line is the QCA.X with the parentheses and CELA, and then the third one is the QCA.draw, just to draw the circuit. I press Shift Enter and see that it's exactly the diagram we want, so A should be correct. So why it is correct? Because the reason is that we have the quantum register INP underscore red, which has two qubits, right? And the ANC, we have only one qubit. So in that case is that we have the QCA.H with the parentheses INP underscore red. So it has the unitary operation acting on the whole quantum register with two qubits. So that's why we have two Hadamard gates. So correspondingly, we also have the QCA.X parentheses and CELA, so which act on the quantum register with only one qubit, so we have the ANZ0 and we have the INP0, INP1, so that's why we generate this kind of quantum circuit. So we can now also see the option B. So it says that we have QCB.H with the parentheses INP underscore red with an other square parentheses 0 colon 2 2, and then we have the QCB.X and CELA with the square parentheses 0, and then we draw the circuit. So for the first code, we have the INP underscore red. It says that we adding this quantum unitary operation from 0 to 2. But in this Python syntax, that actually we just have the operation from 0 to 1, right? We stop at 2. Python is that from 0, 1, 2, 3. So 0 is our first qubit. So in that case, only have the 0th qubit and this first qubit. So we have two qubits in that case. So we have only two Hadamard gates. And then we have the X operation on the ANCilla with the order of 0, so that we can generate the circuit. So we see that it's also exactly what we want to have. For option C, let's see. So in that case, now QCC.H with the parentheses INP underscore red from 0 to 1. So it means that we add on the 0 qubit and stop at the first qubit. So we only add the 0 qubit, only one qubit only. So for QC.X, which is the ANCilla qubits on the 0. So in that case, we have the X qubit adding on it. It can be shown that you have adding on the ANCilla qubit. But there's nothing adding on the INP1. Because the code says that we end the operation on the qubit 1. So for option D is that we have QCD.H INP underscore red 0 and then INP underscore red 1, and then we have the ANCilla 0. So the quantum operation from Hadamard gates adding on the qubit 0 and qubit 1. So we have two qubits. So we have two quantum gates adding on these first two qubits. And then we have the ANCilla 0, which is being added by the X operation. So we have the X gates here. This is about counting. So for option E, we can see that it generates an error. So the error says that the least index out of range. So what happened is that we have QCE.H with the parentheses INP underscore red 1, and then H INP underscore red 2, and then X and CELA 1. So what's the problem is that on the second and the third code is this out of range. So the 2 means that we have 3 qubits. So why is that? Because we count Python is from 0 as our first object, right? So if we have 2, it means that we have 3 objects, 0, 1, 2. right? So at least out of range. And then Enseda, why is it also out of range? Because it counts as one. So it means that we should have zero and one. So it means that we should have two qubits to fulfill this requirement for the unitary operation by X gates and also H gates, right? So we can change it a little bit to make it work. So we change it like 0, 1, 0. So it means that now we have the INP rack that's adding the H adding on a 0, 1. And the H is also adding on the first qubit. And the X is also adding on the enceder of the first qubit. So that's why we can draw this circuit. And then now we get to the option F. So for option F, we have QCF.H INP underscore rack and then QC.H INP underscore rack. So we add this hammer gate two times, right? And then we have the QCF.X adding on enceder. So it means that we're adding on all the qubits in this register one time by H and then second time also by H. And then we have the enceder, the whole register with the qubits inside adding by X. So we can see that we have two hammer gates because it's being added by two times, we have two H, right? So that's why in the first two lines in the stuff, we have the INP0, INP1 is being added by two hammer gates. And then we only have one operation of X adding on enceder ANZ0, so we only have one X gate. So that's why option E is incorrect. And also option E is also incorrect. Option C is also incorrect, so the remaining answer is ABD. So in this kind of question, we can choose multiple answers, not only one. So bear in mind that you should check all the options before answering the question. And also this question is asking about your knowledge in Python, but not really in quantum circuit or quantum registers. And all this knowledge has been taught to you on the first two episodes. You can check it in our code. And there are some references regarding quantum circuit and register, you can review that. So if you still have any questions, you can comment below to let us know and we can answer you as soon as possible. That's all for this episode. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Don't forget to like, share, and comment, and even subscribe to our channel. We are Quantum Grid. Please support it. See you next time. Ciao.